Ils m'attendent du bon esprit. A tout bonnet. D-U-B-B-A-N-T. A tout bonnet. Of the village priest, the school of young ladies. I wish to know if you have heard this question for Miss Pauline Brown. Brown! V-L-O-W-N A-P-K. With an E. She wishes to bet for the valuable boss to squat.
Okay, Abby Stanley, if you go with you. Will you close the door?
Oh, yes, madame.
Do not get frightened, my chère. You have done nothing wrong. I simply wish to ask if you are coming to the bus as well.
Oh, yes, of course. I've altered my frock. I'm going to school.
Do you have a friend to take you here?
Oh, yes, I had a letter today. He's arriving by car from Paris.
From Paris, you say?
Oh, yes, from Paris.
Then why is this bus not for Nice?
Nice? Oh, dear.
Do not worry, little boy. Your secret is safe with me. But just tell me one thing.
Yes, madame?
How does it happen that one so sweet and charming as you has to pretend to have a, how do you say, boyfriend and write yourself love letters?
Oh, it's because of my father, madame.
Your father?
Yes, you see, when he dies, I should be really extremely wealthy. He thinks that every man who makes advances to me is just left in my fortune.
So he forbids you to have one?
Well, practically.
Is he inventing?
Yes, I'm afraid so.
I see. Poor little rich girl. I do have a letter today from your father. He's coming here this morning.
Daddy, coming here?
Yes, he's waiting to learn on business. When he comes, I will have a little break with him.
We won't listen.
We will see. Try your eyes and go to your class.
Hey, excuse me, why not?
That is all right, Mr. Zafir. I was just about to go. So I need to gain my duty time. Trust me.
What was she saying to you, Pump?
Oh, nothing. My father's coming here today.
Your father? What a thrill. Is he handsome as well as rich?
Will you wait and see?
Wait for me, Polly. I left my dog back here somewhere.
Where on earth could it be?
Guess who?
Polly! You're crazy to come here. If Madame Dupoli found out, I would be asked to leave under a cloud.
Oh, she won't find out. I came the back way.
Then we must leave at once. Anyone might come in and find us here together.
Well, I'm not leaving until I make you promise one thing.
Oh, and what is that, may I ask?
Well, you know as well as I do.
Do I?
Yes. I want you to dance every dance at the ball tonight with me.
That's out of the question.
Come on, Maisie, be a sport. You know, there's no one I want to dance with but you.
Really? I don't believe it.
Oh, anything?
But I did. You must live at once.
Okay, but remember, I'm your dancing partner tonight.
Well, perhaps. I'm not promising anything.
You don't have to. I'm telling you.
Goodbye. Andrew is gone. Bobby, Bobby, wait for me.
I should tell
my
mother to make
a show. Thank you. Hi, Madame Duvalier.
How do you do, madame? I hope you'll forgive my visit. It's such a notice, but I felt that while I was in the south of France, I should visit my daughter's school.
Yes, quite so. We are all so wonderful, I say.
A sweet girl takes after her poor mother here. I wish I could see more of her, but I'm sorry to know. It's business, you know.
Yes, I understand, monsieur, but I'm sure you would not pity before Polly's happiness.
Polly's happiness? But she's perfectly happy, isn't she? Never complains in her letters.
Oh no, I'm sure she does not. But, monsieur, there are some things a young girl cannot discuss by post.
No, such as what? Her heart. Am I to take it, Madame Dubinet, that you're referring to love? I sincerely hope nothing of that sort is allowed to occur in school.
No, no, I did not think of it on the premises. Mais le jeune père savant, le jeune fille, n'est-ce pas?
I don't follow you, madame.
Surely you have not forgotten how you French, Michel Pan. Or should I call you mon petit garçon?
What? You haven't. It can't be.
But it is. Do not remember your little
This is impossible. Most awkward.
But this is no way to make an old friend after all we have been to each other. Have you forgotten how Mrs. Knight and Maxime when you...
Yes, madame, I have. Completely forgotten.
But surely not. I walk her quite twice and you can nearly call. Et quand tu m'as tenu, Tommy, you meet un champagne. Let's call me those in the office to play the words which is on the page in Paris. Let me see. How did it go?
Thank you.
She wants to be alone.
Bye, Father.
Bye.
Come along.
I don't play that I am psychic. No one will get.
maiden's name.
Polly, I have a visitor for you.
Oh, Teddy! I'm so happy.
Hi, my dear. I'm very glad to hear it.
Has he arrived yet, Polly?
Oh, yes, he's arrived. He's really arrived.
Nonsense, Hilda. Nothing like a change from routine for old people like us. I feel 20 years younger.
And behaving accordingly, I get this. Really, you've got to help Ken after our loss.
Now, Hilda. After all, Tony isn't dead, is he?
He might as well be. Sometimes when I think of the disgrace, I would rather he were.
Oh, come now. The boy has done nothing wrong.
Nothing!
Thank you.
here.
Oh, you! What's the matter, Hortense?
Do you know who he is? He's just a messenger boy from the stores.
What are you saying about? He's awfully nice.
If Madame Dubin knew that one of my young ladies!
Oh, please, Hortense, let me talk with you.
Well, shall I go?
I'm not too late. It won't be a minute. Dear Hortense, don't betray me. I know that he's just a messenger boy, but he's doing it because he's poor. And I'm sure that in reality he's as well born as I am.
Perhaps so. But he has no right to make advances to a young lady like yourself.
But he thinks I'm just a secretary.
You told him that?
Yes, I did.
Ella, class, don't you are sure?
Oh, please, Hortense, don't let on to anyone. I'm so happy to have admired Rosita's interest in my wealth. Surely you must know how I feel.
Perhaps I do. But if Madame Dubonnet should find out...
Oh, that isn't my future, her.
All right, ma petite. I give you my thoughts. After all, it isn't Valentine's Day.
Oh, thank you, Hortense. I shall not forget.
Oh, look, here come the other young ladies.
Oh, let's go, Tony. I don't want to meet them just yet, but you do chatter so. All right, Polly, let's not go over to the phone now. Goodbye, Hortense, and remember, shh, you promise.
I say, was that Polly?
I'm sure it was. I recognize the walk.
Oh, look, there's Hortense. Hortense, do tell us, was that Mademoiselle Boy with her book?
I have no idea.
Oh, yes, you have. Come on, Hortense, do tell.
Yes, do tell, Hortense.
Hortense, tell me, is it how you slick and handsome?
I have no idea who you are talking about.
Oh, isn't she mean? If you just tell me what it's like, Hortense, I'll give you that tender juice sachet, and I'll give you a squishy flower.
C'est vous, mademoiselle. It is not seemly to be so curious about a young man.
And why not? Haven't you ever been curious?
Well, I...
Maybe not, thanks. I believe you have.
So true.
Well, Bess is not so prima, she pretends, eh?
Oh la la!
Of course she isn't. After all, she is French.
Yes, I am. And I'm very proud of it, too.
All right, Kiki, but I don't think I want to paint after all.
But why not, Shahid? It will do you good.
I can't swim.
I think you're telling me to swim. I'm sure you can swim just like a fish with your little big muscles.
Thank you, dear. Ticklish.
I know. I remember.
Please, Jimmy. Someone will see.
Who cares? This is a Riviera. But come along. We are going to our bed.
But I haven't got a bathing costume.
Ça ne fait rien.
You don't think I should bathe without?
No, no. But I know where I can look for one for you. So, you wait here. I'll quit down. That's an instant.
But Kiki.
Au revoir, petit poisson.
I say, the chap.
Were you addressing me?
Well, I wasn't addressing the chap. As a matter of fact, I was wondering if you could help me. You seem to know your way about here. All the jolliest girls. You see, I have the wife with you, and she's not a bad sort, really, but she doesn't understand me.
I'm afraid I can't assist you with your domestic affairs.
That's not domestic affairs I'm talking about. It's foreign ones, I've just. We may wish one or more must stay together, you know?
Yes, of course.
What about the young lady you are dealing with just now? She seems like a spotted little filly.
Spotted little filly? Really, sir, let's ask you to mind your language. That lady is a highly esteemed member of the community.
Yes, I'm sure she is. In manners, she seems so much better in France.
She is, sir, a headmistress.
I say, you are in luck, aren't you? Oh, here she comes. Here the chap introduces us.
Yeah, merci, the latest model.
I've changed my mind. I'm going straight back to the hotel.
But Percy, I've got you such a lovely costume. You mustn't disappoint me now.
Yeah, do as she says.
I've had enough of this. I'm leaving at once.
Are you Percy? But what have I done?
I say, you're upsetting her. There's no way that she's a headmistress.
Will you please go away?
But Percy, will you not introduce me to your friend? Perhaps you'd like to go living instead, yeah?
By Jove. Well, you're short.
Keep it, Matt. Complete stranger to me. And I've never met him before in my life.
Well, this is not my good plan. We can afford to dispense. I like this formality. Is it not?
Maybe, monsieur. Vous avez raison.
I don't know what that means, but it sounds absolutely delicious.
High time to realize things are very different from what they used to be.
Ah, oui, merci.
Yes, most definitely.
Thank you.
Maisie. Maisie, here you are. I've been looking for you everywhere.
Have you? I've been for a swim with Dulcie and Faye.
Just Dulcie and Faye? You sure there wasn't anyone else?
But there was. I can go maybe with whom I choose.
Why wish you'd choose me?
I don't want to choose anyone in particular.
Why not?
Because I want to have a good time while I'm young. After all, I am only 17.
Why don't you show me a good time? Isn't as if I've got plenty of cash.
Money isn't everything.
Well, how about you come and see my yacht again? You like that, didn't you?
Oh, yes. It's a very dinky yacht. Hello, Marcel.
Mom's here, Maisie. You look grubby, son. Don't forget, you promised to dance a tango with me tonight.
Of course not.
Maisie.
Oh, yeah.
Mademoiselle Maisie, you look enchanting. Tonight you and I will dance a two-step, yes?
I can hardly wait.
Oh, Maisie.
Hello, Alphonse. I do want to dance with you at the ball, and so you shall.
Maisie, you listen to me.
You listen to all of us.
Oh, extremely, but it's just the first of lots of wonderful meetings, isn't it?
Yes, at least I expect so.
But why shouldn't it be? Remember what you said this morning?
What did I say?
Surely not. Oh, Marcel, tell me quickly, who are that lady and gentleman?
Sorry. watch how much more momentum it takes to affect your skin.
Everywhere.
and it's not fair. Mason, you planned this.
What if I did? They'll just have to put up with it, won't they, girls?
Yes.
Okay, so we will. But at least we can make time pass quickly.
Oh.
We can dance.
Yes. I think in spite of all, she
loves you too.
Do you want to swim?
Yes. So if you promise not to run away.
Oh, I do, Hortense, and mercy be good. Well, I better go get changed into my costume. I was just about to take it back to Ken Stone's, but thankfully I ran into you.
Do not let me yet, Mom.
She will not come at all.
Although my head is turning.
sit down and order the garçon to bring us a glass of port.
I require anything to drink, thank you, but I intend to return to the hotel in a few minutes and I shall expect you to accompany me.
Very well, my dear. Garçon! Bring your lady a glass of port.
Look, everyone. Here comes Molly.
Let me, Dr. Monroe. I know how she is feeling.
What a lovely girl.
So let the girl be spontaneous this afternoon.
Are you sure? Maybe it is. I'll have a word with her.
No, but we'll both have a word with her later.
Yeah.
Only good, Tommy. Want to answer? But of course. You know you're so wise to come to the boss as well. When one is feeling sad, the only thing to do is try and forget.
Oh, I should never forget.
I shall have. In the meantime, why not try and enjoy yourself? Look, you have all your friends around you, so do not be downcast.
Hello, Polly. So glad you've come.
Yes, we wish I mad taking chats.
Yes.
Thank you. It's so nice to know I have some real friends.
Thank you.
Madam, is my daughter, and I am Percival Brown.
Percival Brown? The millionaire?
Yes, dear. I'm afraid I've deceived you too. I'm not a secretary after all. Can you forgive me?
Of course, my girl.
Well, it seems love is in the air.
It is indeed my turn, Kiki.
But of course, she will be the first to know.
Very well, then, Polly. Madame Duvenet is consented to become my wife.
Greatly appreciated. I'd also like to indicate that Posthumous BC has been awarded to Kate Bonner, who's been working backstage. There's been a group of former pupils who've come to help backstage, front stage, and in a variety of other respects, and we're very grateful to them. Can I make a suggestion to the former pupils of here tonight? As we move towards the millennium and the big event we hope in August of the year 2000, it might be appropriate for you to start thinking about getting organised as a group, and then you could give a lot of support and we could give a lot back to you. I think one thing that has to be commented upon tonight is that in this performance we've seen the most amazing costumes. And that's me thanks to the parents who have worked so very, very hard in producing, I think, the best costume show we've ever seen. There was a point this year, I think it has to be said, when it looked like there wasn't going to be a show at all. That was really because Mrs. Cunningham decided to extend her October break. Also gave a new meaning to the expression October break. On the assumption that she does not choose to do the same thing next year, and you understand that she's actually being kept in. She's grounded again. While mentioning Mrs. Cunningham, it occurs to me there's someone who's never on the programme who really needs happy to go back tonight, and that is her long-suffering husband who makes appointments to see us. I'm coming from somewhere in the audience, but I'd like to thank him for his appearance. Just before I wind this up, I need to tell you that next year's show will be Godspell. It's still Godspell, but that is long. She's put me in a position before of announcing next year's show and changing it. Finally, before these young folk make one or two small presentations that I believe is about to take place, I think we need to congratulate all the young people in the hall tonight. Those on stage, those down here in the pit. It's all right, it's not rude. Those who've been front of stage, backstage, operating, lighting and so forth, could you just take me a bit off the top, please? All of them. We've seen them come up from, you as parents have seen them come up from that size. We've seen them come up from that size. It's been really great watching them grow, watching them develop, watching the wonderful things they can do. Some of them are finishing tonight, their last show. It would be unfair to single out any of them. But just let me say this, there is no truth in the rumour that Andrew Patterson is going to work with a company which recycles cardboard boxes.
Thank you. Livingstone.